Well, to another development story, the path has been cleared for Nigeria's Ngozi Okonjo-Iweala to become the first woman and the first African to lead the World Trade Organization after South Korea's candidates pulled out of the race for the job. Okonjo-Iweala, an economist and former finance minister of Nigeria, already enjoyed broad support from WTO members, including the European Union, China, Japan, and Australia. However, the United States under the Trump administration had favored you, complicating the decision-making process, since the selection of a new leader requires all WTO members to agree. Okonjo-Iweala's formal selection may have to wait until after the United States appoints a new trade representative. Of course, Okonjo-Iweala spent 25 years at the World Bank as a development economist, rising to the position of managing director. She also chaired the board of Gavi, which is helping to distribute coronavirus vaccines globally, stepping down at the end of her term in December. This is big. Already we're having several African economists and leaders congratulate the economist Okonjo-Iweala on this new feat in her strides to become the next Director General of the World Trade Organization. But let's now bring in Frank Ejekum, the Executive Secretary of the Ghana International Trade Commission, for more on this developing story. Frank, we're grateful that you joined us. It's now official. We've heard it on various international news media that she made it. What will be the prospects for Africa?
A pleasure to be on your program once again. Yes, it is good development for Africa. If for nothing at all, it does increase the prestige of Africa to have an African at such a high-level position as the WTO Director General, which is good. You do realize that our own Alan Chematin tried some time ago, but we couldn't make it for various reasons. So Nkonjo's eventual assumption of that high office is good. And also because she has indicated her desire to stick to multilateralism, in which areas, for instance, he believes that Africa under the Africa Continental Free Trade could also benefit. And she's talking about the need to make the WTO a truly multilateral organization that will benefit the whole of humankind, where the rules and regulations and the laws of the organization are bring up to speed in terms of modern trends. You do realize, for instance, there is a lot going on in terms of e-finance in the world, but we don't seem to have, she believes that the WTO regulations are not up to speed in that respect. And it is because she believes that unless all the organization itself has its laws modernized and enables all others to come on board, it may not be as effective as she thinks it is. Also, she's talked against plurilateralism, where a group of nations are able to benefit more from the regulations and rules of the organization, because they are more ready to take advantage of the institutions that it provides, while others are not. He doesn't think this provides an even playing field for everybody, and he thinks that those things should be looked at so that all nations who are signed up to the WTO agreement benefit equally from it. So it's good news for us, and it's something that all Africa should be proud of.
But yet again, we cannot, you know, place all our eggs in one basket. Definitely, she wouldn't be serving the interest of Africa exclusively. She is the World Trade Organization's Director General, for God's sake, others could argue. So how then can she position herself in a much more strategic way to better the interests of African trade?
Yes, certainly. She's not talking in terms of only benefiting Africa, but the WTO is there to serve all nations. And if we talk about liberalism in trade and economy on the wealth front, it should be inclusive of all nations. So where you have institutions that have been structured in such a way that some parts of the world are benefiting more from others.
You were positioning the potential of Dr. Ngozi-Iweala when it comes to African prospects, investment, and whatnot.
Yes, so that's right. So so I was saying that she's trying to bring the WTO regulations in line to such a point where all nations can benefit from it, because as we do have it now, Some nations are ahead of others, and that sort of creates a great playing field for everybody. But that also means that for countries like Africa who are missing out on the big scale, on the bigger issues, would also have on our own to up our game in terms of our skills development, e-commerce, e-finance, and all those things. Because the future really is in there. If we don't do that, the multilateral aspirations of the World Trade Organization cannot be met. And have a situation of polylateralism where a few nations who are ready and prepared and up to speed group up to then take the benefits of the organization to the exclusion for others.
Interview that she granted Bloomberg just about some few months ago regarding the concern of where she's coming from, Nigeria, the stark developmental challenges there as against where she's headed, the WTO, where so much development and so much leading countries being member states having to rule when it comes to development and trade partnerships. There is a huge mismatch here. How does she bridge this particular gap going forward?
Well, so, I mean, the advantage Africa has is the future, that we have a young population that is could be a good advantage for us in the future. But how do we make use of the future? Unless, of course, the youth is up to speed in terms of the skills, capacity development, and we are able to match, as you say, the developed countries who have already gone ahead of us. And that part specifically is a problem and the issues Mrs. Okunla is trying to resolve. How do you bring an organization that would be in tune with the modern times and yet be able to serve the purposes of all? She has talked about the need to try and link up or seek greater cooperation between the WTO, which is a regulatory organization, and some of the funding institutions, such as the World Bank, where she worked for many years, IMF, and et cetera, who are then able to collaborate in such a manner that we are able to impact and benefit from the finances that accrue from these other organizations that can help developing countries such as Africa to come up to speed in terms of capacity building and logistical upgrade, so we are able to benefit from some of these very good ideas and very good strategies that are on the international scene. And she is very well placed to do it because of her long experience in the World Bank and in other international financial institutions. So coming at the helm of affairs of WTO, she's able to merge those experiences from the World Bank and from elsewhere, and also as a finance minister of Nigeria, who did so very well, so therefore understands the problem of Nigeria. And of course, the problem of Nigeria is the problem of much of Africa. Therefore, she's able to bring a wealth of experience together that is able to address some of these issues. So I think it's good for Africa, and we must be proud and happy that good times will come.
Well, Mr. Jokum, let's now end narrowing down to Ghana. In your initial submission, you made mention of Mr. Alancho Mantin, the trade and the trade minister who once vied for this position way back some years ago. Now, as a Ghanaian economy, having to see a Nigerian economist take on this huge role, it dawns on us various challenges and various responsibilities as well. How do we position ourselves, especially when it's not just going to be about Ghana, nor Nigeria, nor the continental free trade? It will be about the global economy. How do we reposition ourselves to take advantage of her position at the WTO?
Well, I must say that one good vehicle we have in Africa is the Africa Continental Free Trade Agreement, which seeks to bring together all of Africa in terms of trading and in terms of economy, so that we can, so to speak, speak from the same hymn sheets.
All right.
So those are the regulations that are in place that Africa should try and strengthen. And I think that the AFTA has come at a very good time, where multilateralism seems, and from the American president's point of view also, we believe multilateralism will soon be taking the center stage again. So I believe we are in good speed. All we need to do is to implement the various protocols, the various agreements, the various agendas that we have on the Africa Free Trade Agreement. And then the whole of Africa will begin to benefit as much as we can. Yes, I know, and we should know that not all countries, even in Africa, would benefit on the same level, but at least would have made an attempt to ensure that we have one common policy that ensures the benefits of our continent.
Mr. Franco Chukwuma, we're so grateful that you joined us. He is the Executive Secretary of the Ghana International Trade Commission.